How many of you can feel his presence, his glory? Hallelujah. That's what I celebrate, that the glory is in the house. Hallelujah. Now, I don't know if I will do the message on the two brides. I mean, the armor bearers were reminding me, I promised it. But if I do, you will see in the text. And that's one of the things I celebrate. That in heaven itself, that the only shout around the throne are two things. Amen and hallelujah. I say, my God, we have two of them in this house. I say, resurrection. Let's show heaven what we can do. Say hallelujah. Amen. And amen. And amen. Amen. Lord, we give you praise. We welcome you to your house. Thank you for loving us and for tabernacling with us. Your presence is worth more to us than any number of people we will gain, or any money you give to us, or any material thing as far as that is concerned. Your presence is heaven to us. Your presence means the world to us. We celebrate your presence. We honor your presence. We magnify you for loving us, and we give you praise with joy in Jesus' name. 3 Amen. As I was coming into the service this morning, this is why God says, do not forsake the assembly of yourselves. I know we have the video, and that has been a seduction for so many people. But there are blessings reserved for those who make the sacrifice to come and worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because as I was coming in service, this thing happened to me in my spirit. It was like a knowing that my Heavenly Father is so big and that he can handle every problem in this room. No. Okay. No, I was telling you that he corrected me. I said, he can handle all the problems in this room. He tapped me and said, no, I am bigger than all the problems in this room. Hallelujah. So I don't care what you came with. You need to start magnifying him. He's bigger than it. He's greater than it. He's about to show you. Hallelujah. One-on-one. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Bless the Lord. Come on, you need to receive it and let it change your attitude this morning. Let it change how you feel. Let it change what you're thinking. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. It don't matter what you're talking about. It is small potatoes this morning. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. Isn't that what they were singing? They said, let the King of Glory come in. Yeah. I told you those things are prophetic. God always chooses the song they sing before I come in. Hallelujah. You need to open up the gates this morning. Let the King of Glory come in. You should not remain the same. You shouldn't think the same. Hallelujah. Watch. He's just said to me, you need to teach the people what you do. When life starts overwhelming me and things, problems everywhere, I don't pray. I just go and lay down before him. I say, Lord, I'll wait on you until you take me on. And I just worship him and lay there. I can lay an hour. I can lay 2 hours. And then he suddenly comes. Amen. And he will give me a tongue to pray. And I can pray in seconds. And all these mountains will fall apart. Amen. Because that is not the original tongue. That is the supernatural. And boom. These things lift. And I get up. You may have caught me, you know, 2 hours ago in the dumps. And then you catch me now. I'm back on the mountaintop. Because he has repossessed me. Whatever that's on my mind is dethroned. Hallelujah. At least in this service, you can keep praising and keep shouting until it happens to you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Take us on 101. Repossess us 101. Hallelujah. Dethrone every giant. Dethrone every obstacle. Dethrone every doubt and fear. Dethrone every devil. In Jesus' name. That's what the cockpit looks like. Hallelujah. So you have to be able to keep up with. This is not all of it. You have a whole panel on the left, have a whole panel underneath. And you have, you know, some airplanes who have overhead. When you look at it, you wonder, how will one person keep up with all of it? But we practice. That's the way the spiritual life is. You keep working on it, and suddenly, it all makes sense. And when something happens, you know where to look. Hallelujah. When I was leaving Sugarland to go to Addison, Texas, which is a suburb of Dallas, so I was avoiding the big airports with airliners. You have to make a reservation where you're going to park, and you have to pay landing fees and all of that. So I avoid all of that to find this suburban airport. But when I was shutting down, I landed in Sugarland, I noticed something. It hit my spirit. I said, okay, that looks like something was wrong. But then when I came to crank up to go to Addison, Texas, I noticed that I've lost an alternator. My left alternator has failed. All right, so, well, that's why you need twin engines. So if something fails in one, then you have redundancy. So I called Atlanta, asked Emmanuel to check with the management company. They said, no, you're fine. Just don't fly at night. Just come back during the day, because you don't want to deal with double alternator failure at night. Mm-hmm. Years ago, when I was flying my pastor, we were coming from Memphis, Tennessee in winter. We left about 1 a.m. to come back because we had an 8 o'clock service. And I kept watching the ammeter. Ammeter is what shows you the voltage. All right. And it kept tripping like this, throughout that trip until we landed. And then, because we were using Epps airplane, so I always go back after Sunday service to pay the bill because we're renting airplanes from Epps. So when I got to Epps, they said, now, how did you get back? I said, well, I got back just fine. They said, you had double alternator failure. Wow. But God held it up. He kept providing voltage until I shut down. And it won't crank again. Hallelujah. That's what I tell people. I got in aviation, not because I love airplanes. No, God sent me. So I fly with total confidence. There's no issues. No issues. He would tell me even in advance if there's a problem. Like he kept pricking me that, you have an emergency. I didn't know what it was until I got back to the plane. And that one alternator flew just fine until I came back yesterday. Amen. I went from Sugar Land to Addison, from Addison to Baton Rouge, from Baton Rouge to Newnan, Georgia. Amen. Glory to God. Now, okay, I'm going into my message because the testimonies are linked. So, when I got back to the Galaxy FBO, I said to myself, I know God is with me and has been with me, but where are the miracles that happen during Glory Fall USA? I said, why should this trip be different from Glory Fall USA? Amen. I said, I need to see evidence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That the same glory on Glory for USA is on this trip. Hallelujah. Amen. Now watch. So I go to the counter. And even when my nephew was bringing me back, I told him, now, if you look at their FBO and their facade and all of that, you know that this is money. It's expensive. So I get to the counter. Two pivotal things happened after I made that inquisition. I got to the counter. She said to me, our gas is $8. I said, wow, that's steep. He said, how much have you been paying? I said, $5. He said, well, we have our own discount, but it was 50 cents of the price. I said, what a massive discount. Anyway, I don't know if I texted or called Deaconess. I said, listen, they said they have some kind of a program, membership program. So, of course, you know her. Ding, 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 ding. She's already signed me up and sent me my number. So, as the lady kept looking to see, I said, are you all a member of CAA? CAA is an organization that, aircraft owners sign up, and then they have CAA companies all around America, and you get gas discounts. So she said, no, but I'm not seeing your airplane. I said, wait, if this might help, I have a Challenger jet. Amen. I said, no, you need to look with the Challenger and see if you can find something. She said, well, I don't think we are really part of CAA, but let me see what I can do. And she went, no. She said, all right, I'll tell you what. I didn't know what she did. She said, now, do you want your receipt printed out or emailed? I said, printed out, I want to see. I don't want to discover later. She gave me the receipt. She sold me the gas at $4.06. 50% off. I said, now we are talking. This is glory for USA. I said, now I feel home, you know. What? I left the counter to go use the restroom, and I ran into this tall, white guy, huge guy. I think he's a pilot. And he looks at me and said, good morning, sir. I said, that's a first. I said, good morning. I said, I've never seen a white man greet me. I said, that's significant. Maybe the glory has not come on me. Eh? And he saw something.
Amen.
So I left and went, you know, to the airplane and got going. Then I got to Baton Rouge and went to see my relatives and ate something. They took me back to the airport, you know, got everything all set up, and then took off. Coming back to Atlanta, because I wanted to come back in daylight. And I had everything all set up. And suddenly, the Holy Spirit said to me, put in a demand on the anointing. He said, that's what you did. If you hadn't said anything, everything would have continued. He said, go and teach them that. The glory that came down was so good. I had everything set up, cut the autopilot on that used to act up, and he was flying the plane. I took out my iPad and wrote the message while the airplane was going. Wrote the entire message. Put away my iPad and resumed flying. Hallelujah. The first thing the Holy Spirit said to me, to share this with you, and whether you're watching online or you're in the house, he said that the anointing is a treasure of God's grace entrusted to you. He said, the anointing is a treasure. Amen. Let me deliver you today by opening your eyes. So Satan will not trick you anymore. Amen. Pay attention. They say, read my lips. You are anointed.
Amen.
It doesn't matter how you feel.
Amen.
Okay. No, he said to say it again. You are not waiting to be anointed. You are anointed now. The reason you don't know that you are anointed is because you are living by your feelings. The anointing is in your spirit, not in your emotions. The anointing can impact your emotions periodically, but the resident grace is locked down in your spirit. Hallelujah. Man, I feel his strength coming on, eh? And when you finally acknowledge him, you notice he said, if you acknowledge me in all your ways, I will direct your steps. But you keep acknowledging how you feel. You keep acknowledging the devil and what he's doing. He said, acknowledge me. Say with your mouth, I'm anointed. I put a demand on that resident anointing in my spirit to run over this enemy, to overcome this obstacle, to overcome this financial issue, this relationship issue,
The power is in my spirit. Act like you're anointed. Think like you're anointed. Shout like you're anointed. Make decrees like you're anointed. Stop praying to be anointed. You already are. Look at 2 Corinthians 4. It says, for God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, had shined where? In our hearts. To give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of? I can't hear you. I say in the face of
Jesus Christ.
Look at verse 7. But we have this treasure in
earthen
vessels. He said, we have it. This treasure. This grace. This anointing that God has granted us. He said, it is in vessels of clay. Is with us knucklehead human beings.
Amen.
With all our shenanigans.
Amen.
He says it's a treasure.
Amen.
How do you handle your treasures? Do you leave your diamond rings on the kitchen counter? You don't even take it off when you wash your hands.
Amen.
When you go to the public places. When you get, it's only when you have fake. You look good until you need to contact water. So you have to take it off and wash. Because if you wash it in the water, hallelujah, it will lose its glory. My point is, you protect treasure. You guard treasure. You always make sure you know where your treasure is. Hallelujah. I pray that your life will change this morning. Because once you receive that the treasure is in you, you will live differently. You will think differently. You will act differently. Why? You are protecting the treasure. What Satan does is to send the scorpion to you. They sting you. And you erupt. You don't remember you are carrying a treasure. You start venting your emotions. And he fouls up your treasure by your utterances. Because death and life and the power of the tongue. So the tongue has power to release life or death. So Satan keeps working on you to keep releasing death. And I'm teaching you, when you get upset, the first thing you do is to hold your tongue.
Amen.
Don't say anything.
Beloved, sometimes God will just quicken truth to us. And he just blesses us and refreshes us. I was on a trip, and it dawned on me that the miracles that follow me when I'm traveling with my leaders in Eagle One was not following me, even though I was alone. And I said, no. It's the same grace, the same anointing. And as soon as I put a demand on it, the gas went down to 50%. Things started happening. And then while I was on the trip back to Atlanta, this word came to me, placing a demand on the anointing, on the grace that you have already received. One of the biggest faith failures I see in the kingdom of God all through the earth is that people don't have confidence in their prayers, confidence in the grace and deposit God has made in their lives, and they keep looking for somebody else to get the prayer through for them. When you are sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise, you've been given the measure of faith. God said to me, the anointing he's already placed on you is a treasure of God's grace in you. You will give account of it one day. start depending on it. Excuse me. Start putting faith pressure on it. And you see that it will rise to produce. You have what it takes. You are already anointed. You are not praying to be anointed. If you just get that, God has changed your world this morning. You are anointed. You are already graced. Your faith will work. In Jesus' name, amen. This mystery has held me all through these years. That's why I don't run from pillar to post chasing anything. The people I will be chasing got their breakthrough from the same God I'm calling on. No, it's only a matter of time. The same grace will produce for me. He said that God is rich to all those who call upon him. So I can't be chasing the yesterdays of God when I can live in today, in the today of God. It is your word. It is your challenge. It is your season. This is your month of deliverance. Your month of breakthrough. I'm declaring it. Your breakthrough is in my mouth. Your miracle is in my mouth. Your own side is your faith response to what I'm saying. And God will answer you. Amen. Write today. Let me hear your testimonies. Write today. Glorify God in your testimonies. Write today. Put a seed to thank God for the voice of resurrection. To thank God for what this broadcast is doing in your life. Amen. You enter his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Amen. Are you ready? And if you're low and discouraged or going through anything, the prayer line is there, 770-994-3777. There's a few watching on the other parts of the world. You can use our WhatsApp number to reach us, and the prayer ministers will still be here ministering to you in love. And God will answer their prayers, because they are my sons and daughters, and God answers my prayers. And the evidence abound everywhere. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Act on it today, whether it's for your seed sowing, or for you calling the prayer line, for you writing to give your testimonies. Those are your three faith challenges. And if you ignore your feelings and act on your faith, God will meet you and God will honor you. Amen and amen. You are carrying God's treasure. You are anointed. You will prevail. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.